Now, a completely different situation, complete reverse of circumstances. You have 28-31 in March of 08, and you have 31-28 sometime in January and February of 09. Now, as soon as this happened, you will recollect, I think it is important that I load to you the facts accurately as possible, because I noticed from all the articles that have been published, the accuracy of the facts are a lot to be desired. I think you should know the facts before we discuss this matter. Now, as soon as these three persons decided to be independent, the Speaker of the State Assembly of Perak then introduced three letters and said they have resigned because apparently they have tendered resignation letters. Now, this was, of course, very much disputed by all the affected state assemblymen, because they said they never resigned. In fact, it then transpired that they have apparently signed undated resignation letters, which, as a matter of law, and I must stress this, as a matter of law, it has been declared to be illegal sort of mechanism as early as 1983 in the case called Dato' Ong Kee Hui versus Senyum Anak Mutip in Sarawak, where the court held that the whole idea of democracy is freedom of the voters, and the freedom of the voters is translated to their representative, who should be free to act according to his conscience. He cannot be a puppet where you held by the string and you pull him, even by the political party. The political party should not be doing that, because this guy should be completely independent. And if you are holding a Democles sword or an undated resignation letter, it really interferes with his freedom and therefore unlawful and unconstitutional, in fact, against Article 55, among many others that they have quoted. Now, that is the situation with the resignation letters. But in spite of that, the Speaker decided that the three state assemblymen will not be allowed to enter the state assembly, because as far as he was concerned, they have resigned. Now, he then invited the election commission, because he declared the seats vacant and he wanted the election commission to hold by-election in the three constituencies. Now, what did the election commission do? The election commission obviously got their own legal advice. And I must tell you that the legal advisors in the election commission, from my own experience, is just not merely one or two. Sometimes they resort to outside legal advice, very experienced legal advisors, and they came up with the correct legal point, namely that they are the one who decide whether a seat is vacant or not. They are the one. In fact, if you look at the Constitution of Perak, I believe it's 35.4, Article 35.4, says that it is the Election Commission who determines if a seat is vacant. And if you go to the Election Commission Act of 1958, the same thing is repeated, that it is the Election Commission that will finally have the say for whether a seat is vacant or not for a by-election. Now, that is clear. Now, the Election Commission, therefore, refuses to hold a by-election. That has become a subject matter of a suit from the Speaker, I believe, who has filed